The countdown is on, just 2 weeks until Election Day.
On News Channel 8 at 10, all month long, we are profiling the candidates who are running for Congress in Iowa. Tonight, the second district race between John Archer and Dave Loebsack. News Channel 8's Laura Nichols introduces us to Representative Loebsack.
Growing up in Sioux City, Dave Loebsack was one of four children raised by a single mother with mental illness. The family lived in poverty, barely able to skate by each month.
We had my mom, my grandma, four kids in a little two-bedroom place, one bathroom, and it was tough, there's no doubt about it.
At a very young age, Loebsack made a vow to himself that would shape the rest of his life.
To be honest, in the fourth grade, I decided myself, truly, in the fourth grade, that I was not going to live in poverty in my adult life.
From then on, he took school seriously, making studying his top priority. Loebsack's high school principal saw his potential, but knew he couldn't afford college, so he offered him a job as a janitor.
I took him up on the offer, and that's how I got through Iowa State University, and a lot of other jobs along the way, too.
Loebsack went on to get a master's degree from Iowa State and then a Ph.D. from the University of California at Davis. From there, his love of education led him to become a political science professor at Cornell College in Mount Vernon, Iowa. In 1995, he married his wife, Terry. They have four children and three grandchildren. In 2006, the college professor knew it was time to make a change. That change would be running for Congress.
President Bush was clearly taking the country in the wrong direction. There needed to be a change in the House of Representatives, a change of party, but a change of personnel as well, and that was an argument I made throughout.
Loebsack defeated a longtime incumbent to win Iowa's 2nd Congressional District. He was reelected in 2008 and is now currently serving his third term.
Laura Nichols reporting for us there. Our commitment coverage continues tomorrow with a look at candidate John Archer.